हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10th, वेलकम टू डीएवी मॉल पब्लिक स्कूल। आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर जागृति मेश्राम। लेट्स बिगिन आवर टुडेज ऑनलाइन सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द न्यू टॉपिक व्हिच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड दिस ईयर इन योर सिलेबस एंड दैट इज एनालिटिकल पैराग्राफ राइटिंग। Let us first of all know what is analytical paragraph writing. Analytical paragraph present evidence in order to prove and support your thesis. Now let us see what is thesis. Thesis is a statement that declares what you believe and what you intend to prove. These analytical paragraphs are based on charts, tables, maps or graphs, as you can see in the picture. Dear students, every analytical paragraph should include these three elements. First is introduction, which means introduce the thesis. Second is body, elaborate your analysis. And third is conclusion, conclude your analysis. So these three are the three elements of analytical paragraph, that is introduction, body and conclusion. For making this more clear, let us see one question. The paragraph below gives information about changes in the birth and death rates in New Zealand between 1901 and 2101. Summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. Dear students, on the basis of this graph, we have to write the analytical paragraph. You can see this black line refers to the birth rate and this gray line refers to the death rate. Dear students, x-axis shows the years and y-axis shows the birth and death rate. Dear students, now let us see the graph very carefully. What we can see that the graph shows the changes in birth and death rate in New Zealand since 1901 till 2101. Here you can see the birth rate starting from 1901 up to 2101. So this will be our introduction, that is the graph shows changes in the birth and death rate in New Zealand since 1901 and forecast until 2021-01. Dear students, remember that your introduction should be very short and crisp. Dear students, now let us once again analyze our paragraph by seeing the graph one more time. What we can observe that in 1951, the birth rate has increased up to 66,000 and in 1901, it was 20,000. Also, we can see the birth rate is declining up to 45,000 in 2101. It means that there were lot of fluctuations. So, our body paragraph 1 according to our observation will be like this. Between 1901 and present day, the birth rate has been consistently higher than the death rate. It stood at 20,000 at the start of this period and increased to a peak of 66,000 in 1961. Since then, the rate has fluctuated between 65 to 50,000 and it is expected to decline slowly around 45,000 births by the end of the century. Let us see what will come in our body paragraph 2 after observing the graph once again. In contrast, the death rate started below 10,000 and had increased steadily until present time. This increase is expected to be more rapid between 2021 and 2051, when the rate will probably level off at around 60,000 before dropping slightly in 2101. So, what will be our conclusion after writing all this? Overall, these opposing trends mean that the death rate will probably overtake the birth rate in around 2041, and large gap between the two levels will be reserved in the later part of this century. In this way, dear students, you have to write the analytical paragraph based on the graph, chart or pie chart. Dear students, based on our today's session, here is one short assignment for you. Study the chart given below and complete the summary in about 80 words. So, dear students, have a nice day. Thank you.